Hello students, this is Nita Shetty, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, AJIT Mangalore. So in today's session, we'll be studying about LR0 parser and SLR1 parser. So in my previous session, I already started with the bottom-up parser. So now we know what is bottom-up parser and what are the different classification of bottom-up parser. So this figure shows the classification of parser. So the parser is categorized in two types. One is top-down parser, one more is bottom-up parser. Top-down parser is classified into two types. One is without backtracking, one more is with backtracking. So with the backtracking, we call it as a non-predictive parser. Without backtracking means it is a predictive parser. So under predictive parser, there are two types. One is recursive descent parser, one more is non-recursive descent parser. It is also known as LL1 parser. So we have solved the problem related to LL1 parser. We know what are the two important functions in LL1 parser, that is first and follow. Next, we have constructed the parsing table and also we have parsed the given string. So that is about the top-down parser. So the previous session, I started with the bottom-up parser. We know what is bottom-up parser. Bottom-up parser is also known as shift-reduce parser. Bottom-up parser is also known as shift-reduce parser. Okay. So we have solved the problem related to shift reducing, that means we have passed the given input string. So basically there are two actions, the one is a shift action or the one more is a reduce action. So using that shift and reduce action, so we have passed the given input string. So now the bottom up parser is classified into two types, that is operative precedence parser and LR parser. Okay, and also in the beginning I have told all the parser, it won't support the ambiguous grammar except the operative precedence parser. So the operative precedence parser will support the ambiguity grammar, but other than this operative precedence, all other grammar doesn't support ambiguity grammar. Okay, so now today's session we are studying this LR parser. Under LR parser, for your syllabus, they are given only two parser, that is LR0 and SLR1. Okay, CLR1 and LR1 is not in your syllabus. Okay, so these are the four category of LR parser. So anyhow, we are studying in detail what is the meaning of LR and what is the meaning of each LR, SLR and CLR and LALR. Okay, but in detailed study, we are going for LR0 and SLR1. So let's begin with LR parser. Okay, so first you should know that LR parser is a type of bottom-up parser. LR parser is a type of bottom-up parser. Okay, now why the name is LR? Okay, what does this first L and second R mean? Okay, so the meaning is the most prevalent type of bottom-up parser today is based on the concept called LR, okay, K parsing. So here LR. Okay, so the first L, the meaning is left to right scanning of the input. Okay, so the given input, it is scanned from the left side, okay, towards the right. Okay, so starting from left to right. Okay, and second R indicates that it's a construction of rightmost derivation in the reverse. So what is the basic classification, I mean difference between the top-down parser and bottom-up parser? Top-down parser follows LMD, that is leftmost derivation, whereas the bottom-up parser is rightmost derivation but in the reverse order. Okay, so here the L, first L indicates that we are scanning the input from left to right, and second R indicates that rightmost derivation, that is a reverse of rightmost derivation. Reverse of rightmost derivation. Okay, that is a main meaning. Okay, and what is this K? So K means number of input symbol of look ahead, that means how many inputs you will consider. Okay, each time how many inputs you will consider. So each time we will look at one input string, so we are dealing with LR1 parser. Okay, so remember students, here first L indicates that left to right scanning of the input, and R indicates that construction of rightmost derivation in the reverse order, and K is a number of input symbol of the look ahead that are used in making a parsing decision. Okay, so K can be 0 or K equal to 1 for practical input, or we shall also consider LR parser with K less than or equal to 1. When K is omitted, K is assumed to be 1. That is, the meaning is, if I just write LR, okay, the meaning is the K value is 1. Okay, or I can write as an LR. 1. That means at the time only one input is taken. Okay, that is the meaning of L pass. So here students remember, L means the input is scanned from left to right. R means it is a rightmost derivation, the reverse order. K means how many characters are seen in the input. Okay, that is a look ahead character. So that is the meaning of LRK parser. Okay, so LR0, the LR parser classification, as I told, it is a LR. The LR0 means left to right 0. So 0 means how many input you have seen. So that if I write 0 also, the meaning is one input is seen. Or if I can just write LR, okay, that means I'm seeing only one input. Or I can say write only LR1, the meaning is one input. Okay, I mean one character in the input. So if I write LR2, the meaning is two input is seen. Okay, that means two characters are seen in the input. That is the meaning. So what is SLR1? SLR1 stands for simple LR. Okay, so simple LR, and LALR means it is a look ahead LR. LALR means it is a look ahead LR, and CLR means it's a canonical LR. Okay, CLR1 means it is a canonical LR. So that is the meaning of LR parser. So the LR parser, first category is LR0, simple LR parser, look ahead LR parser, or canonical LR parser. Okay, and this classification I am reading from the left side towards the right side. So leftmost parser is having a less, it is a very less powerful parser, whereas a CLR is a most powerful parser. Okay, so LR is a simple but is a less powerful, whereas CLR is a most powerful parser. But here in this syllabus, in module 4, you are studying only in detail, we are going to study only LR0 and SLR1. Okay, so now remember, so we have studied LL1 parser, right? So what were the components of LL1 parser? In LL1 parser, just recall the top-down parser, in that LL1 we have studied. So we have constructed LL1 parsing table, right? So there we have constructed LL1 parsing table. But here we are constructing LR parsing table. Okay, so there in top-down parser we studied LL1, there we constructed LL1 parsing table, but here we are constructing LR parsing table. So there we need input buffer to read the, to store the input data. So here also we need input buffer to read the input data, and we need LR parser algorithm. Okay, so we need LR parsing algorithm and stack to store the symbol. Okay, stack to store the symbol. And remember students, all these four parser, the stack, input and LR parsing algorithm is same. Okay, for all these four parser, stack, input buffer, LR parser and LR parsing, stack, input buffer, and this is LR parsing algorithm is same for all four parser. Only the difference is in the LR parsing table. Okay, so LR0 there is a parsing table, SL1 simple little modification is there, and for LALR and CLR also LR parsing table varies, but input buffer, stack and LR parser algorithm remain same for all four category of the LR parser. Remember this. Okay, so only the difference is LR parsing table. Okay, now in order to construct LR0 and SLR1, we need canonical representation or canonical collection of LR0 item. Okay, so later I'll be telling what is that item, but for timing you remember, in order to construct LR0 and SLR1, we need canonical collection of LR0 item. And in order to construct LALR and LCLR on parser, okay, we need canonical collection of LR1 item. Okay, we need canonical collection of LR1 item. So what is that item? What is that LR0 item? I'll be explaining now. Okay, so remember, in order to construct LR0 and SLR1 parser, we need canonical collection of LR0 item, whereas LALR and CLR1, we need the canonical collection of LR1 item. Okay, so let's begin with the first one, before starting LR parser, so let me explore what's the common feature in LR parser. Okay, so the common feature in LR parser is, so we have studied LL1 parser, right? So in LL1 parser, to construct LL1 parsing table, so we studied two functions, that is first and follow. Okay, hope it is remember, in top down parser we studied LL1. So to construct LL1 parsing table, we need to study the two important functions, that was first and follow, right? So here to construct the LR parser, okay, all four parser, that is LR1, SLR1, CALR or LALR, all those parser, it needs two important functions, and those two important functions are closure and go to. These two are very important function of LR parser. Okay, so in order to study LR parser, we need to study these two function, closure and go to. Okay, whereas LL1 parser, we need to study two function. So that was first and follow. So okay, here we are studying two function. One is closure and go to, whereas in LL1 we studied two function, first and follow. Okay, so let's begin with the closure and go to. So then you'll understand what is that closure and go to in LR0 parser and in SLR1 parser. Okay, so now one more thing I told here, in order to construct this LR0 and SLR1 parser, we need canonical collection of LR0 item, right? So now what is that item? So let me explain that item go to and closure. Okay, so let me explain that item closure and go to in LR0 parser itself. Okay, so let me begin with LR0 parser, and in LR0 parser I'm explaining what is that item closure and go to. So students, please remember this item and closure and go to, the meaning remains same in all the parser. Okay, so let's see what is that item, what is that closure, and what is that go to. Okay, now consider a grammar. Okay, so now I'm talking about LR0 parser. So consider a grammar. S gives AA, S gives AA bar B. Okay, S gives AA, S gives AA bar B. Okay, so now for any grammar, so this is a given grammar. So the question assume, construct LR0 parsing table. Okay, the question is construct LR0 parsing table for the given grammar. Okay, now, so for any given grammar in LR parser, what we should do is we need to add some extra production. Okay, so in LR parser, for the given grammar, we need to add some additional production. Okay, what is that additional production? So additional production we call, see here, what is the starting symbol? Yes, sir, right? So yes, sir, right? Yes gives AA. So here the, so starting symbol is S right here. So I'm adding an additional production. So that is, I'm writing S dash gives S. Okay, S dash gives S. So here, why I'm writing S dash gives S? Because S is a starting symbol. So if E gives AA, I should write E dash gives E. Or X gives AA, I should write X dash gives X. Or if it was Y gives AA, I should write Y dash Y. Okay, so now we call this entire grammar as augmented grammar. Okay, this entire grammar is known as augmented grammar. Hope this is clear, students. Now, so the given grammar was S gives AA, S gives AA bar B. Okay, now what I did is I added a new production S dash gives S. I added a new production S dash gives S. Okay, so that time, and I am rewriting it, S dash gives S, S gives AA, and S gives AA bar B. Okay, now this entire grammar is known as augmented grammar. This entire grammar is known as augmented grammar. Okay, now we'll see what is item. Okay, so item means any production has dot in the right hand side, it is known as item. Okay, any production dot in the right hand side is known as item. Okay, now you see here, now S gives, for example, let me see here, for this production I'm writing S gives AA. Okay, S gives AA. Now I have put dot here, right? So for this production there is a dot in the right hand side, am I right? See, the production was S gives AA. Now I have put dot in the starting, in the right hand side. Okay, so there is a dot in the right hand side, so this entire thing we call it as an item. Okay, so what is the meaning? See, in a bottom up parser, we are starting from the bottom, we are starting from the terminal, then we are going to the top, right? So how we are going to the top? So we are reducing the terminal, right? We are reducing the terminal, then we are reaching. Okay, so here the dot indicates that at the right hand side,
So here, before dot, there is no variable. The meaning is no variable to reduce. Okay, next to see here, yes, use a dot a. So here before dot, there is one variable. The meaning is a has to be reduced. Now again, you see here, yes, use a dot. So there is 2a before the dot. The meaning is 2a has to be reduced. Okay, so what is the item? In the any production, the dot in the right hand side is known as item. Okay, any production, the dot in the right hand side is known as item. So what is the meaning of that item? So here there is a dot here, but before dot there is no variable, so that means nothing to reduce. But here there is a dot, and left hand side of the dot there is a variable. The what is the meaning? A has to be reduced. So here before dot there is 2a. The what is the meaning? 2a has to be reduced. So this is a meaning. Okay, so we call this as an item. Now, what is a closure and go to? Okay, so now let me explain what is a closure and go to. Okay, so the closure and go to is, so this is a actually I'm explaining LR0 parser also. Along with this, I'm explaining LR0 parser. So the given grammar was this: S gives AA. S gives AA bar B. Okay, so now first what you did, the first you did, you generated augmented grammar. So how you generated augmented grammar? S dash gives S gives AA, S gives AA bar B. Okay, so now this is your augmented grammar. S dash gives S gives AA, A gives AA bar B. Now what you should do is, first step you generated the augmented grammar. The second step in the LR0 parser is take LR0 item for the first production. That means you need to generate LR0 item. Okay, what is LR0 item? So dot in the right hand side. So what's the first production? Okay, for S dash gives S. Okay, now create the item. Create the item means you need to put the dot in the right hand side. Okay, now when I put dot in the right hand side, S dash gives dot S. Okay, see, this is your first production, S dash gives S. So I'm creating an item. So how I'm creating an item? By putting dot. Okay, so now S dash gives dot S. Okay, now once you create an item, next step is you need to apply closure and go to function. Okay, see students, you need to do three things. First, you need to generate an item, then go for closure, then go for go to. Okay, so see here, S dash gives dot S. That means you are take LR0 item. That means you are creating an item. Okay, now once you create an item, you are going for closure. So now what is closure? What do you mean by apply closure? When there is a dot in the left hand side of the variable, add all the production of the variable with the dot in the beginning. Okay, add all the production to the variable with the dot in the meaning. So what is the meaning now? See here, S dash gives dot S. Okay, now this is an item. So now in the item, okay, when there is a dot in the left hand side of the variable, so the S is a variable, right? S is a variable. So yes, in the left hand side of the S, can you see a dot? Yes. So yes, left hand side of the S, there is a dot. Okay, now when there is a dot, you need to write all the production of that variable. So what is the production of S? S gives AA, look at the grammar, S gives AA, okay, and you need to write all the production of the variable with the dot in the meaning. So now S gives dot AA, okay, so now you created this. Okay, now this is one more item. Now again you can see a variable A with the dot in the left hand side. Okay, now there is a variable A with the dot in the left hand side, so you write its production. How? A gives a dot AA bar dot B. Okay, now here there is a dot, but the right hand side of the dot, okay, it is not a variable, it is a terminal. Okay, the variable is A. Left hand side of variable, there is left hand side of this capital letter A, there is no dot, there is a terminal, right? So here also there is no variable, so I'll stop it here. Okay, so what I did now, first I created the item for the first production. So when I create an item, I'm getting what? S dash gives dot S. So when there is an item, so item means when there is a dot in the left hand side of the variable, you need to apply closure. So what is closure? Closure means writing all the production of that variable by placing dot in the beginning. Okay, so now yes, so there was a variable S with the dot in the left hand side, so I wrote the production of S. Yes, the production according to the grammar is AA, so I wrote AA and it
to place dot in the in the beginning. So I put dot. Now when I put dot here, this is also an I term, okay, but there is a, again there is a variable with the dot in the left hand side. So I write the production of A also. So I'm writing the production A. So A, again I should put dot A dot B. I'm stopping it here because, so there is no variable in the left hand side dot, okay, because this is a terminal. So I'll stop it here, okay. So now this is closure. Okay, so LR0, what you should do, first you need to generate augmented grammar, then you're creating item, then you're applying closure. Once you apply closure, what is next step? Next step is go to function. What is go to function? So go to function means you generate another state by moving the dot to the right hand side. Okay, so we are, let me show the transition diagram next slide. Okay, so, but before that, you should know what is go to. Go to means you're creating a new state in the transition diagram by placing dot to the dot, by placing dot to the right hand side, by moving a dot to the right hand side. Okay, so generate another state by moving the dot to the right hand side. Okay, so after, once you generate a new state, okay, that means after moving the dot to the right hand side, again, you need to apply the closure. Okay, so again, will be going go to again closure. So you need to repeat until you get final item. What is that final item? Final item means dot in the right hand. So you need to do this, apply, you need to apply this closure and go to again and again until you move this dot to the completely right hand side. Okay, so this is nothing but LR0 parser procedure. Okay, so students, recall what we are doing. First, we are creating augmented grammar. Then we are creating an item. And for that item, you are creating enclosure. And once closure is generated, you are going for go to. Okay, again in go to, we need to apply closure. We need to do this until we reach to the final state. Okay, final item. Final item is dot in the right hand side. So let me explain clearly with the diagram. Okay, so you can see the image here. So this was my augmented grammar. S gives AA, A gives AA bar B, and S dash gives A. Okay, so actually the starting grammar was only so much. S gives AA, A gives AA bar B. Then I added a new production, S dash gives S. So this totally we call it as an augmented grammar. Okay, so next what I did is I created an item. How I created an item? S dash gives dot S. S dash gives dot S. Okay, now when I create an item, now I should apply closure. Why I need to apply the closure? Because in an item, so there is a variable with the dot in the left hand side. Okay, there is a variable with a dot in the left hand side, so you need to apply the closure. Closure means writing the production of S with the dot in the beginning. So I wrote the production of S. S gives AA, I place dot. Now again I can see a variable with a dot in the left hand side, so I need to write the production here, A dot A and dot B. So this totally we call it as an we finished here. This first state we completed here. Okay, so first closure we completed here. So next, after completing this, we need to apply go to. So what is go to? Go to means you're creating a new state by placing a dot in the right hand side. Okay, you're moving the dot to the right hand side. Now see here, now the dot, look at the first production, dot S. Now I want to place this this dot to the right hand side. Okay, see here, there is a dot S. So I want to create the new state by placing dot to the right hand side. So after placing dot to the right hand side, it becomes S dot, right? So now look at here, the production is S dash gives S dot. S dash gives S dot. That means I place the dot to the right hand side. S dash gives S dot. Okay, so now I got this new state. How I got this new state? By changing the dot in the variable. Okay, so which variable? S variable. So you can see here, look at the arrow mark. I'm seeing here from this to this state, I'm creating new state. I'm writing in a old shape here, new state, and the transition I'm showing for S. Okay, variable S. Okay, variable S. So look at the second state here. Okay, now second production, now I need to move this dot to the right hand side. Okay, right hand side of variable A. So for variable A, I'm moving the right hand side. So now I got the production as S gives A dot A. Okay, so dot was here. When I move this, dot comes here. So A dot A. So S gives A dot A. Okay, for which variable I move here? For variable A. So I'm writing that variable A here. Now again, you got a new state, S gives A dot A. Now when you see here, this is an item. There's a dot in the item. Okay, and in that item, so there is a variable with the left hand side, variable with the dot in the left hand side. Am I right? see here, sqs a dot a. Now you can see a variable with the dot in the left hand side. So when you see a variable dot in the left hand side, again you need to apply a closure. So what is closure? Writing the production of a with the dot in the beginning. So what is the production of a dot a a bar dot b? So I completed this. Okay, so whenever you apply go to, okay, along with that you need to apply closure also. Whenever there is a possibility, so you need to apply closure also. Okay, so now see here again. Okay, now I completed this two production. I'm in third production. So now where is a dot here? So I need to move this dot to the right hand side. So I'm getting a dot a. Okay, I'm getting a dot a. So for which terminal I'm moving here? Small letter a, small letter a. Okay, so I'm writing a, use a dot a. Now again I can see I term where there's a variable dot in the left hand side. So I need to write a production of a also. So I'm writing a, use dot a a bar b. Okay, dot a bar b. Okay, so now again you can see here the dot a gives one more production is there, right? A gives dot b. So I'm moving that dot to the right hand side, a gives b dot on the variable b. Okay, so I completed the all the productions here. So I'm getting a new state. So all these four are new state. Okay, so is there any final item here? Yes, this is one final item. Why we call this as a final item? Because the dot is moved towards the right hand side. So after dot there is no variable. So this is also final item. Why? Because dot is in the right hand side, there is no variable. So this and this we call it as a final item. But this two is not final item. Still I can apply, can I apply go to and closure? Yes, still I can apply go to and closure. So again, for this state you apply go to and you create a new state. Okay, then for that you need to apply closure. Again for this state you need to apply go to and closure. So let me come and show it. Now see here, so this four state I got in a previous diagram. Okay, this four state I got in a previous diagram. So now I told this and this is a final state, this and this is a final state. Why? Because there is a dot in the right hand side. Okay, so now from this state, okay, now I'm in this state. So again I'm going for the go to operation. Okay, when I go to operation, so I'm moving the dot to the right hand side. So I'm getting what? S gives a a dot. Okay, so I'm getting what? S gives a a dot. So can I write a new state over here? S gives a a dot. So I can see here S gives a a dot. So on the transition of the variable a. Okay, now come back to here. Again move the dot to the right hand side. So a dot a, a gives a dot a. I think I already wrote that state once again right here in the previous. So once again new state I'm not writing, so I'm just showing the arrow mark to this state. Why? Because after transition on the variable a, I'm getting a dot a dot a. After on the transition of variable small letter I'm getting a gives a dot a. Okay, and here a gives dot b. After transition I'm getting a gives b dot. So once again new state I'm not writing, I'm showing the arrow mark to the same state which is already we obtained. Okay, so it is a gives b dot. Okay students, see here, from this state I create new state here, and on the dot small letter a and small letter b I'm just showing the arrow mark to this state, and this state once again I'm not writing because I'm getting it again and again. Okay, so this I completed. Now come to this. Okay, a gives a a dot. Okay, so a gives a dot. So you can see here a gives, look at here, a gives a a dot, a gives a a dot, a gives a a dot on the transition of capital letter a. Okay, a gives a a dot. Here a dot a. Okay, so here what I'm getting, see here a dot a. Okay, so I'm getting same step again, right? So I'm just loop here, a gives a dot a. See here I'm showing a loop, a gives a dot a, and I'm getting a gives b dot. So I'm showing from here, see, a gives b dot. And students, please write and practice, it is easy. Okay, so here, see here, so this from here we got this state and this state. So from here I'm putting a loop over here itself, and for a gives a dot I'm showing this arrow mark. Again for a gives b dot I'm showing this state once again. Okay, so now whether we first I completed with I completed this and this already in the previous slide. So now I completed this and this. Okay, now I got again new state. So whether it is a final item? Yes, final item. So can I move it once again dot? No, not necessary one more state, because already we have reached the
final state for all, all the state is final, right? Because a dot is the right hand side here, so there is a dot in the right hand side. I think anymore I cannot apply go to and closure. This is the end. Okay, so this is the end. I cannot apply go to and closure once again. Okay, so you need to apply until you reach the final item. As I'm getting a final item, so once again I'm not applying a go to and closure here. Clear? Okay, now. Okay, so next. So now I said in LR0 parser, in order to construct the parsing table, you need to apply item, closure and go to. Okay, so now we applied item, go to and closure. Hope it is clear for everyone. Okay, now let us see how to construct LR0 parsing table. How to construct LR0 parsing table. Okay, so now before constructing the parsing table, what we should do is, so this we got, right? So this diagram is known as canonical collection of LR0 item. Okay, this diagram is known as what? It is known as, I'm writing here, this diagram is known as canonical. Okay, it is known as canonical collection of LR0, canonical collection of LR0 items. This totally, this diagram is known as canonical collection of LR0 items. So in order to construct the parsing table, first what we should do is, we need to name the state, okay? So in the previous diagram, we got, so all these are new state, right? So first this state, next this state, this and this. Again, we got two more states, right? So what we do, will do is, we'll name the state, okay? So let me name here, okay? It's, you can name it in your own way. You can begin from the 1, or I'll begin from 0. So this I'm calling it an I0, okay? So I0, state number 0, I0. So this is I1. This is I1. So this is I2. This state is known as I2. So this is I3. This state is known as I3. And this state is known as I4. And this is known as I5. And this is known as I6. Okay, so total there are 7 states from 0 to 6. Or you can begin from 1 to 7, no issues. Okay, I have started from 0 to 6. Okay, so this is 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So these are the state number. Okay, now if you know the if you have the canonical collection of LR0 item, then it's really easy to construct a LR0 parsing table. So now let's see, students, how to construct LR0 parsing table. Okay, so in LR0 parsing table, just recall LL1 parsing table. So in LL1 parsing table, so you had rows and column, right? So each column you had variable, and the row heading was all the terminals. Okay, and terminal should end with a dollar. Okay, but here in LR0 parsing table, so here there are two parts. Okay, the main heading, there are two parts. One is go to part, one more is the action part. Okay, and here the number of rows is equal to number of states. Okay, so I0 to I6, so number of rows is equal to number of states. Okay, and whenever there is a transition for a variable, write the new state number under the go to part. Okay, just read the students, then later I'll be showing, so you'll understand. Okay, so when there is a transition of a variable, write the new state number under go to part. So here in the diagram, so this is a transition for a variable, right? This is a transition for a variable. So we need to write this state number under go to part. Okay, and whenever there is a transition for a terminal, okay, see here, this is a transition for terminal, A and A. A, you know what is terminal, small letter character, they are known as terminal. So when there is a transition for the terminal, so this state number has to be written under action part, okay? So this state number has to be written under the action part, okay? With the suffix S. So whenever there is a transition for the terminal, write a new state number under action part with the suffix S. And whenever there is a transition for a variable, write a new state number under go to part. Okay. And when the state contains an final item, what is final item? The dot in the right hand side. The dot in the right hand side, we call it as a final item. So when a state contains final item and that final item is augmented grammar, then we call it as an accept state. Okay. So
When the state contains the final actum and the production of augmented grammar, then is known as an accept state. Okay, and other than that, if any state contains the final item other than augmented grammar, then in that particular row, reduce completely with the production number. Okay, so this I'll be explaining while we construct a parsing table. Okay, but just read these points. If any state contains final item other than the augmented grammar, then in that particular row, we need to write the reduce completely with that production number. Okay, so these are the key points to construct a parsing table. Okay, so if you know these points, very easy to construct the parsing table. Now students, let's begin constructing a parsing table. Okay, so this parsing table is very simple. I told parsing table has two parts, action and go to. Okay, the parsing table has two parts, action part and go to part. Okay, so these are the two parts of the parsing table, action part and go to part. Okay, so now under action part, you are writing all the variables. Okay, sorry, we are under action part, we are writing all the terminals. So this is a given grammar. This is a given grammar. Actually, the given grammar was three production. S gives AA, A gives AA, A gives B. But I added one more production to form an augmented grammar. So it was S gives S dash. Okay, so now what you should do is, when you come to the parsing table, just concentrate on the given grammar. And first production I'm giving as 1, second production I'm giving as 2, third production I'm giving as 3. So please, when you give the number, don't consider the augmented new production. Okay, so while you put the number here, this number is very important. Later you'll understand why it is important. So here, when you put the number, okay, don't put the number for the S new production. Okay, start putting number from the given grammar. So S gives A is the number 1, A gives A is number 2, and A gives B is number 3. Okay, so now under action part, you should write all the terminals. Under action part, you need to write the terminals. So what's the given terminals? Just 2, A and B, right? And always, you know, you should end with the dollar. So action should end with the dollar. Okay, terminal should end with the dollar. Okay, and under go to part, write the variables. So what are those variables? A and S. The variables are A and S. Please don't put S dash. Okay, so that is a new production what you added. Okay, here in go to, you should write just the variables which is given in the question. Given in the grammar, that is S gives AA. And I said number of rows is equal to number of states. So how many states we numbered? I0 to I6, right? So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is number of rows. So hope it is clear, students. Under action, you are writing all the terminals which ends with the dollar. Under go to, you are writing the variables, and we are not considering a new production. And your number of rows is equal to number of states. The number of states from I0 to I6. So I am writing from 0 to 6. Okay, so now let's begin constructing a parsing table. Let's begin constructing a parsing table. Okay, now how to construct this? So see here, look at the production here. Okay, look at the state I0, S dash gives dot S. Okay, production is S dash gives dot S, S gives dot AA, A gives dot A, A bar dot B. So this was your first production, right? So now what I should do is, okay, look at I1, look at new state. Okay, so now we need to check. So here there is a transition from 0 to state to 1 state. See here, this is 0 state and this is state number 1. And from 0 to 1, why there is a transition? So its transition is based on the variable S. S is nothing but capital letter, so it is a variable. So I said, when there is a transition on based on the variable, we need to write that new state number under go to part. So here, from 0 to state, you are going to 1, right? So from 0 to state, so in row, I'm taking 0 to row, okay? 0 to state, okay? So based on the, we are writing that the new state number under go to. Under go to, for which, why you are going to 1 based on the transition? Yes, so under yes, I'm writing 1. See students, from 0 to state 2, I am going to new state 1 for the transition of yes, that is the meaning. Okay, from 0 to state 2, I am going to 1 state. Why? Because for the transition of yes. Okay, now from 0 to state, you are going to 2, state number 2 on the transition of A. Okay, how? See, from 0 to state, I am going to state number 2
for the transition of variable A. Okay, so 1 and 2 we got a new state because of a transition of the variable. So I'm writing that S and A is under go to part. So under go to part I'm writing 1 and 2. Okay, that means I jump from 0 to 1 for S, I jump from 0 to state to second state to for the variable A. Okay, so this is done. Okay, next. Next to see here, I said the any item, if it contains the final item. So what is final item? I1 contain final item, I5 contain final item, I6 contain final item, and I4 contain final item. Am I right? I1 contain final item, I5 contain final item, I6 contains final item, and I4 contains final item. Okay, now all these four variable has a final item. All these four variables as a final item. In this four variable, which is augmented one? Augmented means new production what we added. So new production what we added was, sorry, here this is not S gives S dash, sorry. There is a mistake. This is S dash gives S. Okay. Okay. So new production what we added was S dash gives S, right? So S dash gives S is augmented grammar which is in state one. S dash gives S is augmented grammar which is there in state one. Okay, so I said this is a, it is an accept state. It is an accept state. Okay, so under one, under dollar, I need to write accept. So students, remember, we need to write the accept only under the dollar and in which state? It is state one. Okay, so one under dollar, I'm writing accept state. Okay, hope it is clear, students. Okay, so I jump from 0 to 1 on the transition of variable S. So under S, I'm writing 1. I jump from transition 0 to 2 for the transition of variable A. So under variable A, I wrote 2. And the state 1 contains an augmented grammar. So I'm writing accept. Okay, now, next, here, see here. From 0 to state 2, third state. Okay, from 0 to state 2, third state, why you're jumping from 0 state to third state? Why? Because there is a transition on the small letter A, that is terminal. So when there is a transition based on the terminal, we need to write that state number under the action part. Okay, so state number 3. So from 0 to state on the transition of A, okay, you're jumping to state 3. So I'm not just writing 3, I'm writing S3. Okay, while writing here, I'm just writing 1 and 2. But under action, while you write, you're not writing just a state number. We need to add a suffix S, okay? So S is the meaning is shift, okay? So we are writing S3, okay? So from 0 to state to 4th state, why you're jumping from 0 to state where on transition of B, okay? So from 0 to state, when there is a B, I'm going to the state number 4. Okay, so I'm not writing just to 4 because I'm writing an action part and it writes S4. So that is a mean. Okay. So under A I'm getting S3, under B I'm getting S4, and under A I'm getting 2 and S I'm getting 1 and 1 dollar I'm getting accept. Hopefully this is clear. Okay, so now we'll go to the state number 1. There is no transition and stop there. Now state number 2. Okay, now in from state number 2, you're going for the state number 5 on the transition of variable A. Okay, so from 2, you're going to state number 5 on the transition of variable A. Okay, see, in from state number 2, you're going to state number 5 on the transition of variable A. Okay, similarly, from 2, you're going to the state number 3. See, from 2, you're going to state number 3, okay, on the transition of small letter A. So, from state number 2, you're going to state number 3 on the transition of variable A. So, here, since in action, I cannot write just 3, I need to suffix S3. Okay, I need to put suffix S3. Similarly, from state number 2, you're going to state number 4, on the transition of small letter B. Okay, so from state number 2 on the transition of B, you're going to state 4, so you're writing suffix 4. Okay, this is clear, right? Okay, now we are in state 3. Okay, now in state 3, you're going to state 3 on the transition of A. So from state 3, I'm going to state 3 itself on the transition of A. So I'm writing shift 3 S3. Okay, from state 3, you're going to state 4 on the transition of B. So from 3, I'm going to 4, S4 on the transition of
B. Okay, so I'm in 3, I'm writing as 4. Okay, and here you can see here from state 3, I'm going to state 6 on the transition of capital letter A. So from state 3, I'm going to state 6 on the transition of capital letter A. Okay, so students, this is clear. I complete this, this and this. Okay, now come to the final item. So final item, this is an augmented grammar. So I wrote accept state. Okay, now remaining I5, I6 and I4, what is this? I5, I6 and I4, we call this a final item because there is a dot in the right hand side. We call this as a final item. Okay, we call this entire thing as a final item. Now, where to place that? Okay, so now what we should do is come to I4. We come to I4. Okay, so now in I4, there is a final item. What is item? Production A gives B. Okay, A gives B. Now go to the grammar, see where is A gives B. A gives B. So which production number? Production number is 3. I have numbered it. I told you to number in the beginning, right? So A gives B is a production number 3. So what you should do is A gives B is in state 4, right? So in state 4, entire row under the action, you need to write R3. Okay, that means R means a reduction function, and you need to write in the entire row of the action, entire row under action. Okay, why this is 3? Because A gives B is a number 3. Okay, production number 3. A gives B means production number 3. Okay, I am writing under state 4. Why state? I should write in 4 because this is entire thing is state 4. So in state 4, entire thing I am writing R3. Okay, please remember why I am writing 3, because A gives B is a production number 3. Okay, go to production number 5 and go to state number 5. So state number 5 contains a production S gives AA. So S gives AA is a production number 1. So in 5, I should write R1 in the entire row of action. In the entire row of action, I am writing R1. Okay, for state 5, I am writing R1, R1, R1. Why the 1? 1 here, 1 means S gives AA, S gives A number is 1. So I am writing reduce 1. Okay, R1, R1, R1. Okay, now go to state number 6. Now state number 6, look at here, it is a production A gives AA dot. So A gives AA means which number? That it is a production number 2. Which state? 6. So in 6 state, I should write R2, R2, R2. Okay, reduction 2, reduction 2, reduction 2. So I5, I4 and I6 contain the final item. Even I1 also contains a final item. But that final item is a new one. There is no number. We call it an accept state. Okay, so and you should write that in the dollar itself. Okay, so students, this is LR0 parser. Okay, students, please understand what is LR0 parser. So this we call it as an LR0 parser. Okay, and here in LR0 parser, first we need to apply what item, then go for closure, then go for go to operation. Okay, you need to apply closure and go to simultaneously until you reach the final item. So then in construction the parsing table, there are two things, action and go to. Okay, so when there is no final item, then there is no issues. That means transition of the variable you are writing under go to part, when the transition of the terminal you are writing under action part with the suffix s. Okay, but when the item is a final item, you should remember, you should be very careful when you write a production number and you're writing the reduce function in the entire row of action. So this is known as LR0 parser. Okay, this is known as LR0 parser. Okay, now what is SLR? I said SLR1. So I said SLR1 is same as LR0. That means starting from the augment expression, augmented grammar, you're writing item, you're writing action, closure, go to operation, everything is same. Even the parsing table is the same, action and go to. The difference is last part. So let me explain first that. Okay, so the difference is in SLR1, it is almost same as LR0. Okay, the difference is item is the reduced item is not placed entire row, it is placed in the follow of left hand side. So only that is the difference. Okay, so here students, this grammar, you place R3 in the entire row, you place R1 in the entire row, you place R2 in the entire row, because this was LR0 parser. If it was SLR1, the difference is we are not writing R3 entire row, you are writing in the follow of left, you are placing R3 in the follow of left hand side variable. You are placing it in the follow of left hand side variable. Now listen here, the production was, see here, sorry, not this one, here. Okay, so let me go to the I for state. A gives B. Okay, let me go to I for state. A gives B. A gives B, it is a production number 3. It's a production number 3. Okay, so what I wrote, this is LR0. What I wrote in LR0, I wrote R3, R3, R3. But if I construct an SLR0, SLR1 table, where I should write is, for I should write that R3 in follow of A. Okay, I need to write that R3 in follow of A. I need to write that R3 in follow of A. So what is follow of A? So we have studied first and follow, right? In LL1 parser, similarly here also. What is follow of A? So see here, what is follow of A? Who is following here A? Capital letter A. Okay. So what is first of A? First of A is A. Okay. And B. Okay. And follow is A and B. Okay, and there is one more A here. So here after A there is no one of left hand side variable. So follow of S is dollar. So the follow of A is dollar small letter A and capital letter B. Okay, so I need to write that R3 in here A, B and dollar. Why? Because follow of A was small letter A, small letter B and dollar. Okay, so now look at the next production. Look at the production number I5. Look at the production number I5. S gives AA. So S gives AA. I should write that S gives AA R1. Okay, here you see, you wrote R1 in the entire row. Right? But now S gives A. What is follow of S? Follow of S is dollar. Okay, if it is SLR1, I am writing that R1 only in the dollar. So student, please try to understand the difference. Okay, so here if it was LR0, I wrote R1. But in SLR1, I am writing R1 only in the dollar. Why? Because follow of S is dollar. Okay, follow of S is dollar. Okay, follow of S, see here, follow of S is dollar. So I'm writing that R1 only in the dollar. Okay, not I'm not writing under A and B. Okay, so now next, next production is A gives AA. Okay, A gives AA. So A gives AA, that production number 2, you need to write that R2 in follow of A. Follow of A means it is R2, not R3. So I need to write that R2 in AB dollar, because follow of A is AB and dollar. Okay, only this is the difference, rest everything is same as LR0. Okay, so difference is only so much. In SLR1, that reduction function, you're not writing the entire action, you're writing the follow of left hand side. But in LR0, you're writing the reduction from the entire row of action, not in GoTo. Don't get confused, not in GoTo, only the action, you're writing the entire row. Okay, but whereas in SLR, you are writing only on the follow of left hand side variable. Okay, students, so this is about LR0 and SLR1. Hope it is clear. So now we'll see how to parse the given input string. Okay, so how to parse the given input string. Okay, so let me explain the parsing in LR0 parsing table. Okay, so this was LR0 parsing table, already explained the difference, also explained. LR0, we are writing reduce function entire row, but in SLR1, you are not writing entire row, we are writing the follow of S. Okay, there we got follow of A as AB dollar. Here we wrote R3, this is R2, but follow of S was just dollar, we wrote R1. Okay, this is SR1. LR1. Okay, now I'm in LR0 parsing table. So now I'll show you how to parse the given input string using LR0 parsing table. Very simple. Okay, so let me explain how to parse the given input string in LR0 parsing table. Okay, so assume the given input string is AABB dollar. Now we'll parse for the input AAB. Okay, if they give AABB also, we need to attach dollar, because you know that the dollar, input always ends with a dollar. Okay, so the given input is AABB dollar. Okay, so now let's begin parsing. Okay, now parsing. So the input, see here, I need to consider three things: stack, symbol, and input. Okay, one more is action, fourth thing: stack, symbol, input and action. Okay, now what you should do is, in input I'm writing the given string. What is the given string? AABB dollar. Okay, now stack.
So always remember, when you pass, the star contains your starting state number. So what is the starting state number? 0. Okay, starting state number is 0. So let the star contain the starting state number 0. Okay, now let's start passing. How to pass is, see here. So now what is the top of the star contain? Top of the star contains 0, right? Top of the star contains 0. Okay, now you should see that stack, top of the stack number and first input 0 and A. Okay, so now see, the look at the passing table. 0 on A. What is 0 on A? Yes, 3. What is S? Shift 3. Okay, so shift and 3. That means you need to shift that input A into the symbol. That symbol is nothing, it's a stack itself. Okay, so under symbol column, I'm shifting that first input A to the symbol, and I'm shifting the number 3. Okay, that means I'm pushing the number 3 onto the stack. Okay, I'm inserting number 3 onto the stack. So why I'm inserting 3 onto the stack? Because the looking at the passing table, 0 on A, the action is S3. Okay, shift that input symbol A into the symbol and push that number 3 onto the stack. Okay, now 3 and A, 3 on A. So now 3 on A, again S3. Again S3 means again push that symbol A onto the symbol and again number 3. Now I'm getting what? 0, 3, 3. I'm getting number 0, 3, 3. Okay. So two times I got shift operation. Now 3 on B. Okay. Now 3 on B. Again S4. Again shift that B onto the symbol. Again number 4 onto the stack. So I'm getting 0, 3, 3, 4 and AAB here. Now the input contains only B and a dollar. Okay. Now 4 on B, 4 on B, R3, okay, reduce 3. So what is R3? What is third production? Okay, go back. What is R3? R3 is A gives B. Okay, I need to use a reduce function, gives B. I need to use a reduce function, A gives B. So A gives B means I need to replace this B by A. Okay, I need to use a reduce function R3 and replace that B by A. So remember students, when you replace this B by A, what you should do in stack is, when you replace this B by A, okay, you need to, how many symbol you got? One symbol, right? You replace this B by A. So you should eliminate this number. Okay, what was the star power contain? It contained 4, right? So you should eliminate that number. So I eliminated that. Stack contains only 0, 3, 3. Okay, so once you eliminate that number, you need to insert a new number. How to insert a new number? You see, after eliminating that, I'm getting 0, 3, 3, right? Now top of the stack contains 3. Now you should see that 3 on A is what? 3 on A is what? 3 on A is 6. Okay, now you should insert a new number 6 onto the stack. Are you getting this? Students, see here, 0, 3, 3, 4, there was AAB, B dollar. So now, the top of the stack contains 4 and input is B. Now, when I saw 4 and B, it tells that R3, shift to reduce. Shift to reduce, R3 means, we know that R3 means A gives B. That means, you need to reduce that B by A, okay? So, I'm reducing that B by A. So, one symbol are reduced, right? When you reduce one symbol, you need to reduce one number from the stack, okay? You need to pop one number from the stack. So, assume that 4 is not there. When there is 4 is not there, what does top of the stack contain? Top of the stack contains 3, right? When that 4 is not there, assume. Now, your top of stack contains 3. You should see 3 on A. Okay, new symbol, what to replace? 3 on A. Okay, so 3 on A is 6. Okay, 3. That means here, top of the symbol, what does contain? A, right? So, 3 on A is 6. So, I'm writing 6. Okay, now, next, 6 on B. Okay, so 6 on B is R2. Okay, so what is R2? R2 means A gives AA. So now I need to replace 2 symbol by A. And replace 2 symbol by A. Okay, and it replaces 2 symbol by A. So that means I should eliminate 2 numbers. I need to eliminate this 2 number. Now what is top of the stack contains 3, right? Top of the stack contains 3. So you should say 3 on A. 3 on A is 6. So you should insert new number 6. You need to insert new number 6. Okay. Now 6 on B. 6 on B is again R2.
6 on base again R2, that means your R2 means AA gives A, you're reducing that AA to A, you're reducing AA to A. So when you reduce AA to A, you are eliminating this 2 number. So when you eliminate that 2 number, your top of the stack contains 0. So 0 on A 2, right? 0 on A is 2. Okay, so I'm inserting new number 2. Okay, now 2 on B. Okay, so now 2 on B is S4. 2 on B is S4. So 2 on B is S4. Now shift 4. I mean push that number 4 and push that symbol input to the symbol AB. Okay, so dollar. Now what 4 and dollar? So 4 and dollar R3. What is your R3? R3 means you're reducing that B by A. When you reduce B by A, you should eliminate that 4. Okay, now 2 on A. So 2 on A is 5. Okay, you're inserting new number 5. Okay, so now 5AA dollar, 5 on dollar. So 5A in dollar is R1. So what is R1? What is R1? R1 means AA getting reduced to S. Okay, so here AA getting reduced to S. When you reduce 2 symbol, you need to eliminate 2 number. So I'm getting 0. So 0 on S. Okay, 0 on S is 1. Okay, now 1. Now 1 on dollar. 1 on dollar is accept. So this is how we are parsing the given input string using LR0 parsing table. Okay, so this is how we are parsing the given input string using LR0 parsing table. So remember students, when you find shift operation, you are shifting that number and you are shifting that input to the symbol. Okay, when you find reduce operation, you are reducing that terminal, you are reducing that value by the variable A, and you are reducing that you are eliminating that number from the stack, and now top of the stack, and with the new symbol you are comparing with the LR parsing table and inserting a new number onto the stack again. And if you reduce 2 symbol, you need to eliminate 2 number, and the remaining top of the stack and new symbol you need to compare and you need to insert the number. Okay, so this is how we are doing the parsing. So please write and practice, definitely you'll understand. Okay, so this is simple. So from LR0 parsing table we constructed a we have parsed the given input string A and B dollar. I mean to do this until we go to the accept state. Okay, so students, here I discussed a very important concept about the LR0 parser. So in order to construct LR parser, you need to construct an augmented grammar. Okay, then you should apply the item, then you should go for the closure, then go to, so you need to keep on doing the closure and go to until you get the final item. Until you get the final item, you need to do this. Okay, then be careful when you put the production number. This is 1, 2, 3. Don't put the number from S dash 1, 2, 3. Okay, then you'll be giving the number for the new state. Then you'll construct the parsing table. Parsing table, 2 things, action and go to. And you should remember these points. When there's a transition for the variable, you're writing that new state number under go to. When there is a transition for the terminal, you're writing under the action part. Okay, and here the, what is the difference between LR0 and SLR1? In LR0, that reduce function you're writing under you're writing under action part. I mean, you're writing completely in entire row you're writing, whereas in SLR you are writing the reduce function, the follow of left hand side variable. Okay, so here we discussed LR0 construction of LR0 parsing table, construction of SLR on parsing table, and how to parse the given input string. Okay, so we'll see construction of LR0 parsing table in some other example in my next session. Thank you.